Hello everyone, this is your friend Deepak Khatri, and in today's video, we are going to program an 8051 microcontroller using an Arduino board, but you can also use those cheap USBasp devices if you have one. Now let's get to work. We are going to do this in three simple steps. We are going to install and configure our software first, then we are going to set up our hardware, and then we will write our code and upload it to our MCU. We require three open source software packages, Arduino IDE, AVRDUDE, and the small device C compiler, SDCC for short. I am using Fedora Linux here, and on Fedora Linux, to install the software, you have to type sudo dnf install Arduino AVRDUDE SDCC. Give it your password and the package manager will install your software. If you are using some other distribution, you can use your package manager or software store to install the software. If you are using a different operating system, search and install the software for your operating system. Then come back to this video. Now that you have installed the software, we have to change the AVRDUDE configuration file a little bit for 8051 chip support, specifically for the 8051 variants from Atmel, yes, the AVR microcontroller company. You will find a link to the file and other resources in the description box below. Go ahead and download the file and follow the next steps. Open up your terminal and type sudo gedit slash etc slash avrdude slash avrdude.conf and append the configuration from the file you have downloaded to this file. Save the file and close the window. Please keep in mind, your operating system may have a different location for this file. Find it and append the configuration to this file. Now we are ready for the next steps. For programming our microcontroller, you need a USBasp or an Arduino board and an 89S51 or 89S52, specifically the S variant is required. 89C51 or 89C52 will not work here. You also require some other components. Gather everything up and start building the circuit. Here is a schematic diagram of the circuit. If you are using USBasp, hook up the wires of your USBasp as mentioned in the schematic. Here is a breadboard version of the circuit. Go ahead and complete the circuit. If you are using Arduino, fire up the Arduino IDE and upload your Arduino ISP sketch to it. If you get some error, make sure the connection configuration for your board is correct. Now wire up the Arduino exactly the same as shown in the picture. Now we will write our code and compile it using SDCC. Go ahead and open up a folder in your favorite text editor and create a file with a .c extension like blinky.c. Now you can code along with me or you can just download the files from the link in the description box below. Let's code our first program. Include the 8051 header file. Initialize the delay function. Write the main function with an infinite while loop for looping our LED blinks. For attaching the LED, use any pin number. Here I am using P1_0, which is the first pin of port 1. Giving a value of 1 will turn on the pin and 0 turn it off. Now provide delay after on and off statements. Define your delay function. Just add a for loop inception for wasting computer time, so that we get some delay between blinks. This function is not doing anything useful. We don't have a precise delay here. We are just testing our stuff. We will take a look at clock cycles calibration in another video. For compiling this program, open up a terminal in this folder and then type sdcc-sdcc and the file name if you are using Fedora Linux. If you are using any other Linux distro or any other operating system, it might be different for you. But please make sure that you are in a folder, because we are going to get a lot of file as output from this command. From all the files, blinky.ihx, which is an Intel hex file, is our loading module for our MCU, and we are going to upload it to the 8051 microcontroller using AVRDUDE program, which we configured for 8051 MCU in a previous step. Use the AVR command for your specific programmer. I have listed AVR command both for Arduino and USBasp. If you have followed the steps correctly, you will be seeing a blinking LED. Congratulations to you. You have created your first 8051 project, and this is just a small start for a big project to come. I hope you liked the video. Tell me in comments what type of projects you want in future. Peace.